गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थ्योरम इन इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स एंड दैट इज़ गॉस थ्योरम। दिस थ्योरम इज़ मेनली इंपॉर्टेंट टू फाइंड द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड सम रिलेटेड टर्म्स। सो दिस गॉस थ्योरम इज़ रिलेटेड टू वन न्यू क्वांटिटी विच वी हैव टू इंट्रोड्यूस हियर, दैट इज़ इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स एंड एरिया वैक्टर। सो वी विल बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग फर्स्ट द एरिया वैक्टर एंड इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स। लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म एरिया वैक्टर विच वी कॉल डी एस वैक्टर। इट इज़ वेरी ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड द डेफिनेशन। लेट अस रीड इट, रीड हियर। एरिया वैक्टर इज normally drawn outward vector on a given surface. So firstly let us see this diagram. In this diagram one square is given. This square's total area we have to denote as S. Then if we take a small part of square, then the small part of the square we can denote by ds, which will be lying on the same plane. Now ds vector means a perpendicular line drawn on the area. So a perpendicular line drawn is called ds vector. So this ds vector is called the required area vector. So the meaning is we will be given any area. Total area is S, part of that area is ds, and the perpendicular drawn on that area is ds vector. In case if the surface is not open, if the surface is closed surface like any cube, the side of the cube, so we have to take care that ds vector will always be outward vector, normally drawn outward vector. After that, let us come to now the calculation of electric flux. Electric flux is basically the calculation of strength of electric field related to the given surface. So the meaning is electric flux is always linked with any surface. So if we are given any surface and electric flux we have to calculate, then it is defined as the total number of electric field lines passing perpendicularly through the surface. So we need to see this diagram. In this diagram, we are given a rectangle and we have to find that how much electric flux is linked or passing through this rectangle when it is kept in some electric field. So in this diagram, these parallel set of lines are the electric field present somewhere, and suppose we are asked to find the electric flux linked with this rectangle. So just now in this diagram, the rectangle is kept perpendicular to the electric field. So the number of field lines crossing this rectangle perpendicularly is called electric flux. So number of field lines passing are just now 1, 2, 3, 4. So the electric flux linked with this rectangle is 4. Let us see the second diagram. In the second diagram, this rectangle is not perpendicular to the electric field. So in case when the area or surface given is not perpendicular to electric field, then the calculation of electric flux is done with a formula. So mathematical term for the electric flux is phi. So electric flux d phi linked with the small area ds is always given by the formula E vector dot ds vector. That means for the flux calculation both are responsible, whatever field is given and whatever area is given. So d phi we write for the small flux for the small area. So d phi is E dot ds, that means a scalar product. So the answer will become E ds cos theta. And in case if we have to find the total flux phi, तो वी हैव टू डू इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डी फाई, सो इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ ई डॉट डी एस. दिस वे वी कैलकुलेट द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स. नाउ द पॉइंट टू रिमेंबर हेयर इज दैट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट दिस थीटा. सो रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट दिस थीटा इज ऑलवेज द एंगल बिटवीन ई वैक्टर एंड डी एस वैक्टर. थीटा इज नॉट द एंगल बिटवीन ई वैक्टर एंड डी एस. दैट मीन्स थीटा वी हैव टू ऑलवेज टेक बिटवीन ई वैक्टर एंड डी एस वैक्टर. लेट अस सी दिस सेकेंड डायग्राम. सपोज दिस इज एरिया एस. हेयर समवेयर डी एस इज प्रेजेंट. सो डी एस वैक्टर इज द नॉर्मल ड्रॉन. E vector is horizontal, so the angle between E vector and DS vector is always theta, which we have to use in the calculations. So this way phi will be calculated, and it is a scalar quantity because it is the scalar product of E and DS.